guys with me. I'm gonna be cleaning this table up a little bit and reorganizing some stuff. And I hope that you guys enjoy it. I'm just gonna tell you like one word, but because I feel like I don't do talkative videos that often. They're all never so talkative, so I'm gonna step my game up here. So these are most of my paints. I did do an art haul where I went to Blake Art Materials and I bought more paints, but I still haven't added them to this collection. So what I'm gonna do is add them in here. And the paints that I like buying are Liquitex as for acrylic, because Liquitex is affordable and they work good, especially these little basic ones. They work good. I do like the heavy bodies because they have more texture to them. I have another bottle here. Here, it doesn't align. And yeah, so whatever's in here. These ones are the Blake brand because ever since I've been going to Blake, I kind of was just buying Liquitex off of their store because I've always used Liquitex, but Blake is literally super similar to Liquitex and it has more paint, number one, and it's Blake is a good quality, like beginner art stuff, and just for what I use it for, it works. I don't need any high-end artist stuff like this guy. This is art. These are some samples I got, which I also tapped on in my roof video. Yeah, if you guys are ever in need of good art supplies, go to Dick Blake. It's right here, dickblake.com. And they have some really good supplies. Whether you're a beginner, whether you're a professional, they have mostly all brands. Okay, a new color that I don't have, sap green. The only green I have is this one. Metallic teal for any highlights that I want to do or point of views. I got another burnt umber because I never know if I have enough burnt umbers. There's a burnt umber right here, so that I do. Normal blue for mixing colors, mixing your reds, yellows, mixing your skin tones. Cerulean blue. It's a good blue, I don't have that blue yet. So these blues look similar to the Not I Promise look. They look the same kind of, but I promise. There's a different tint. These are all my acrylic paints that I now have, which is way too many. Plus this one. And then what I also purchased from the art store. Oh, there's one more paint. Light Portrait Pink. What I also purchased from the art store. These are just some sketch pencils. These are free actually because I bought a certain amount of did buy a sharpener, but I think I lost it. And then I also went a few days ago and bought a mini Poskin. I buy a lot of things here and there that are super little. I also got this Hansen pad, which I didn't need to buy. I already had a bunch of them at my mom's house. And that was colored pencils. So I wanted to be fun and try out colored pencil medium, which I'm terrible at. Needs more practice. And the painting I'm working on right now, which his hand needs to be fixed, but this is from a photo I got off of Pinterest. And I'm just practicing my values and stuff. Organizing. I have another. These are all my oil colors down here. Because I'm still fairly learning techniques with oil colors, I'm not in my comfort zone to do a whole big painting with just sole oil colors. That Juice WRLD painting, the sky, I included oil colors because it allowed me time to blend them and make it give it that galaxy effect. But as for like portraits and abstract portraits and all my other style paintings that I do, I have not figured out the way of oil color yet to comfortably paint with them. I've been doing like little practices with them and trying to get better at working with them, so I just need time. But when I do get oil colors, I usually get the Winsor & Newton oil colors. I know there are better ones out there, but these are just the ones that my store carries quickly and easily. All of the base mixing colors. Something spilled on these, like one of my mediums, and I've never cleaned it off. And here we've got some gel pens. I actually need one. I was looking for one of those. Some Micron pens. This is actually my tablet. My tablet pen. Spray on it. paint for possible pours that I could be doing, the paint pours. And it's just also good to have a lot of white and black because those are two good colors that I use a lot. Either my gouache paints or my watercolor paints, but they're cheap, they're not like high quality. Okay, so this is the brand that I use for my watercolor. I think I got this off of Amazon, Royal Langnickel, and they're not, I mean, they're watercolor paints, so I don't really invest in expensive watercolor paints because per paint it's like $7 and I'd rather spend that money on acrylic paints and stuff that I'm confident I'll use. Oh, I see what happened here. Okay, well, I have a big yellow as well for blending. Now I need to wash my hands. And then this is gesso. This is what you put on canvases before you start painting them, and it kind of is a primer for them. I don't really like gesso, but I buy it for when I make commissions so that the paint on the canvas lasts longer. But because I haven't had any recent commissions, I've just left it. It's been sitting in here. I've been sitting down here because I don't use it that often. And then I just have some canvases. So I have this one. These are also from Blake. Blake has the best stuff, so they're not sponsored, but they really should sponsor me though. I'd be so happy. So I'm going to work on that painting today because this is a painting that I really need to finish for my dad. And yeah. I hope you guys enjoy my little art tour video. There's nothing, a lot of my stuff is still at my mom's house. And I'm going to be transferring locations again for snowboarding for a short time. So I don't think I'm going to take all my art supplies with me because when snowboard season comes, I'm really going to be focusing on snowboarding and making not only ASMR videos, but gaming content and snowboard content. And so my artwork is kind of going to be left behind for a little bit. But I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. And let me know if you have any questions. I'll try and answer them. I do also have other brands of paint in here, like this one. Uh-oh. This is a Winsor & Newton color. I don't like Winsor & Newton acrylics. You get such a little paint for the price you pay. I think that compared to the Bourke ones, or even the Liquitex, even these ones, like, it's just such